GPS coordinates, but analyzing at a resolution of a kilometer. So your precision is 10 or 30 meters, and your analysis is at the resolution of a kilometer. And your identifications are checked by the world expert. In that case, maybe we can say you have zero expected error. Or if you're getting your data off of the internet or out of published sources, you're going to expect some error rates, bad identifications, miscue references, something. Okay? Typographical errors. So we can imagine saying, well, I want to look only at the portion of this spectrum, the omission spectrum, that is within the amount of omission error that I'm willing to accept. If I have those GPS coordinates and the world expert checking my IDs, I don't want any omission error, because that would be a bad model. And so I would only pay attention to this part of the curve up here. If I have really dirty data, maybe I'll say, okay, I'll let some omission error here. And so I'm going to come down from zero omission error to 5% or 10%. And if I follow that over to my ROC curve, then I only ought to look at this part of the curve. Okay? So those are two reasons why we shouldn't look at the whole spectrum. Now we can go here. Here's my E value, and on the ROC axis, I'm going to go not to 1, which is 0 omission, but 1 minus E, which is this area has omission between 0 and E, and it's within my tolerance of omission error. Okay? So I go from there over to the curve, and I come down when I hit the curve, I say, okay, this is the proportion of the study area that corresponds to my acceptable level of E, and I'm only going to interpret my ROC curve in this area. Okay? This is called a partial ROC approach. Now, it was very convenient before because I knew that the area under the random expectation curve was 0.5. In this case, I no longer know what that area is. It's somewhere between 0.5 and 0. Maybe it's 0.4 or 0.3. So what I'm going to do is, within this area, I'm going to calculate the area under the observed curve. That's AUC8. And I'm going to calculate the area under the random expectations curve. That's AUC0. Okay? Now think about, in a full ROC world, the perfect model is 1, and the random model is 0.5. So if I take the ratio of the two, the ratio goes between 1, which is a random classifier, very bad model, and 2, which is a perfect one, right? So in this case, I'm going to take the ratio of AUCA to AUCNull. And if AUCA is not elevated above the null expectations, then I'll get a ratio that is 1. If it's below expectations, it's worse than random model, then I'll get something below 1. But essentially, my test for whether my partial ROC curve is better than random is whether my AUC ratio is larger than 1. Okay? So, ideally, and I really wanted to do this when we published this paper, I would remove the names of these algorithms. Because people think that I'm arguing that, oh, GARP is good. No. Remember I told you about no silver bullet thinking. There is no best algorithm. Rather, I want you to see how these assumptions about E versus traditional ROC, where E is 100%, you accept any level of omission, I want you to see how these assumptions about E factor into this. Focus on, this is three algorithms, GINDIS, which is environmental distance in your open modeler algorithm, GARP, and max session. And focus in on the three columns that say E equals 100. That's traditional rock. Okay? And the area under the curve, well, remember, I'm using these ratios. So the ratio of the area under the curve to 0.5, because this is traditional rock, the area under the curve on average for MINDIS is 1.46, and for MAXENT is 1.49, and for GARP is 1.27. So under traditional rock, GARP is a really bad algorithm, or this prediction is a really bad prediction. But if I say, well, I'm only going to tolerate up to 5% omission, look at how things start to change. 1.09 for MINDIS, 1.13 for MAXENT, and look at that, 1.15 for GARP. So all of a sudden, they're not different. And this corresponds to this area. Okay? Now, let's look at E equals 1. So we're only accepting 1% omission right now. So MINDIS didn't have much to say at that right end of the spectrum. So we could follow that more. But here, GARP is 1.08, MAXENT is 1.06, and we use a randomization approach to testing this. And look at this. The GARP prediction is statistically significant, and the MAXENT prediction is not. This is not an argument that GARP is better than MAXENT. This is an argument that all the results change when you use a conceptually improved version of rock testing. Okay? There's a whole paper on this that we'll give you guys to read. But I wanted you guys to get the idea of threshold independent testing, evaluation, which is desirable because it doesn't require threshold assumptions. But you need to think about avoiding those irrelevant predictions. So here's that paper that deals with essentially improving rock